Ladybird presents Ladybird Tales, a collection of well-loved stories read by Wayne Forrester.
The Three Billy Goats Gruff. Retold by Vera Southgate. Once upon a time, there were three billy goats called Gruff. One fine day, the three billy goats Gruff set off up the hillside. They were going to look for some sweet grass to eat. On the way up the hillside, the three billy goats Gruff came to a river. On the other side of the river was a beautiful meadow. In the meadow was the finest grass they had ever seen. There was a wooden bridge over the river, but under the bridge there lived an ugly troll. People were afraid to cross the bridge because of the troll. Every time he heard footsteps on the bridge, he popped out and gobbled up the person who was trying to cross. The three billy goats Gruff were very frightened at the thought of the troll. Yet they longed to eat the sweet grass in the meadow on the other side of the river. After a while, the youngest billy goat Gruff said that he would be the first to try and cross the bridge. Trip, trap, trip, trap went the hooves of the youngest billy goat Gruff on the wooden bridge. Out popped the troll's ugly head. He was so ugly that the youngest billy goat Gruff nearly fell down with fright.
"Who's that trip-trapping over my bridge?"
roared the troll. The youngest billy goat Gruff spoke in a tiny voice.
"It's only me, the littlest billy goat Gruff," he said. "I'm going to the meadow to eat the sweet grass."
"Then I'm coming to gobble you up!"
roared the troll.
"Oh, no! Please don't gobble me up!"
said the youngest billy goat Gruff in a tiny voice.
"I'm far too little and not at all tasty. Wait until the second billy goat Gruff comes along. He's much more tasty than I am."
"Very well," said the troll. "Be off with you. I'll wait until the second billy goat Gruff comes along."
So the youngest billy goat Gruff crossed the bridge and skipped off into the meadow to eat the sweet grass. Then the second billy goat Gruff said that he would try to cross the bridge. Trip, trap, trip, trap went the hooves of the second billy goat Gruff on the wooden bridge. Out popped the troll's ugly head. He was so ugly that the second billy goat Gruff nearly fell down with fright.
"Who's that trip-trapping over my bridge?" roared the troll.
The second billy goat Gruff spoke in a rather soft voice. "It's only me, the second billy goat Gruff," he said. "I'm going to the meadow to eat the sweet grass."
"Then I'm coming to gobble you up," roared the troll.
"Oh no, please don't gobble me up," said the second billy goat Gruff in his rather soft voice. "I'm not very big and I'm not very tasty. Wait until the third billy goat Gruff comes along. He's very big and very tasty."
"Very well," said the troll. "Be off with you. I'll wait until the third billy goat Gruff comes along."
So the second billy goat Gruff crossed the bridge and skipped off into the meadow to eat the sweet grass. Then at last, the eldest billy goat Gruff came up to try to cross the bridge. He was a very big billy goat. His beard was long, and his horns were almost fully grown.
Trip, trap, trip, trap, bang, 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 bang,
went the hooves of the eldest billy goat Gruff on the wooden bridge. Out popped the troll's ugly head. He was so ugly that the eldest billy goat Gruff nearly fell down with fright. But he did not show it. He only stamped his hooves harder. Trip, trap, trip, trap, bang,
Who's that trip-trapping over my bridge?
Roared the troll. The eldest billy goat Gruff's voice was even louder and gruffer than the troll's voice.
It's me, the biggest billy goat Gruff,
he bellowed.
Then I'm coming to gobble you up, roared the troll.
Oh, no, you're not,
bellowed the eldest billy goat Gruff.
I am coming to gobble you up.
And he stamped his feet even louder. Trip, trap, trip, trap. Bang, 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 bang. After that, the eldest billy goat Gruff butted the troll with his big horns. The ugly troll fell off the bridge head first into the deep water. There was a mighty splash, and the troll disappeared. Never to be seen again. So, that was the end of the ugly troll. From that time on, people went over the bridge without fear. Never again did the troll pop his head out from under the bridge to roar,
Who's that trip-trapping over my bridge?
The three billy goats Gruff lived happily ever after in the meadow on the hillside. They ate the sweet grass, and they were never hungry again. Jack and the Beanstalk. Retold by Vera Southgate. Once upon a time, there was a widow who had a lazy son called Jack. They lived together in a tiny cottage. Jack and his mother were very poor. As time went on, they became poorer and poorer, while Jack grew lazier and lazier. Soon, Jack and his mother were so poor that all they had left in the world was one cow. At last, the day arrived when Jack's mother said, Tomorrow you must take our cow to market and sell her. She is all we have left in the world, so be sure that you get a good price for her. The next day, Jack set off for market. On the road, he met a butcher, who asked him where he was going with the cow. When Jack told him, the butcher said,
I will exchange these beans for your cow.
He showed Jack some strange-looking beans, all of different colours. I would be a fool to exchange my cow for your beans, said Jack.
Ah! But these are not ordinary beans, replied the butcher. They are magic beans.
Jack thought what a fine thing it would be to have some magic beans. So he gave the cow to the butcher, put the beans in his pocket, and set off for home.
Look, Mother, cried Jack. I have exchanged our cow for these magic beans.
His mother was very, very angry.
You silly boy! Now we shall surely starve!
In her anger, she threw the beans out of the window and sent Jack upstairs to bed without any supper. The next morning, when Jack woke up, his room was much darker than usual. When he looked out of the window, he saw that a huge beanstalk had sprung up during the night from the magic beans that his mother had thrown out of the window. Jack ran outside and immediately began to climb the beanstalk. He climbed and climbed, but whenever he looked up, the top of the beanstalk...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.